ان الذين كفروا بعد ايمانهم ثم ازدادوا كفرا but those people who reverted to kufr and not believing after declaring iman after attestation then they increased they went on increasing in kufr in disbelief لن تقبل توبتهم their tawbah their repentance will never be accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala وَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الضَّالُّونَ and definitely they are the people who have gone astray إِنَّ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا وَمَاتُوا وَهُمْ كُفَّارٌ and whosoever commits kufr either he is kufr already he is kafir he is in kufr or he has become kafir after becoming Muslim he is murtad إِنَّ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا وَمَاتُوا وَهُمْ كُفَّارٌ and now if he dies as a kafir as a non-believer فَلَنْ يُقْبَلَ مِنْ أَحَدِهِمْ It will not be acceptable from one of them. مِلْءُ الْأَرْضِ ذَهَبًا Although he may be able to present the earth load of gold وَلَوْ افْتَدَى بِهِ To ransom himself from this punishment of Akhira أُولَٰئِكَ لَهُمْ عَذَابُ الْأَلِيمُ For them is a painful torment وَمَا لَهُمْ مِنْ نَاصِرِينَ And there will be no helpers for them. لَنْ تَنَالُوا الْبِرَّ حَتَّى تُنْفِقُوا مِمَّا تُحِبُّونَ You will never be able to reach the level of virtue, the level of piety, unless you can spend for the pleasure of Allah those things which you love. Now you know the subject which was discussed in the Ayatul Birr, Ayah number 177 of Surah Al-Baqarah. That is as if it had been condensed into very small form. لَيْسَ الْبِرَّ أَنْ تُوَلُّوا وُجُوهَكُمْ قِبَلَ الْمَشْرِقِ وَالْمَغْرِبِ وَلَٰكِنَّ الْبِرَّ مَنْ آمَنَ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ وَالْمَلَائِكَةِ وَالْكِتَابِ وَالنَّبِيِّينَ وَآتَى الْمَالَ عَلَىٰ حُبِّهِ ذَوِي الْقُرْبَى وَالْيَتَامَى وَالْمَسَاكِينَ وَابْنَ السَّبِيلِ وَالسَّائِلِينَ وَفِي الرِّقَابِ All this long, you know, ayah has been condensed. لَنْ تَنَالُوا الْبِرَّ حَتَّى تُنْفِقُوا مِمَّا تُحِبُّونَ You will never be able to reach, to achieve the position of virtue and taqwa and piety unless hatta tunfiqu mimma tuhibbun you spend for the cause of Allah you have spent and given away those things which are very dear to you not the things which have gone out of use now they are useless for you they are old no those things which you love which you like which you adore which are dear to you وَمَا تُنْفِقُوا مِنْ شَيْءٍ فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ بِهِ عَلِيمٌ And whatever you will spend for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah knows it. Although you might have done so secretly, without telling anybody. As I told you, the wordings of the hadith are, when you are giving some alms, some charity to a person, whatever your right hand is giving, let not even your own left hand know it. This is the highest level. There should be secrecy. In sadaqat e nafila, additional sadaqat. But zakah, that is farz, that is obligatory, it has to be given openly. But you know the additional sadaqat nafla, what we call, one should try to keep it and conceal it and not to announce it. Kullu ta'am kana hillan li bani Israel, all the food, and does it mean the usual food that was being used in the Arabian Peninsula. All the food was permissible for Bani Israel, for the children of Israel, illa ma harrama Israel ala nafsihi, except that which Israel, that is Hazrat Yaqub alayhi salatu wasalam, he forbade for himself. Actually, as I told you, the meat of camel was not liked by Hazrat Yaqub alayhi salatu wasalam. He decided not to use it. So actually it was a personal choice, personal like and dislike, personal decision. But then you know the Bani Israel thought that this is haram. This is not permissible. And they were objecting to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the Muslims. How they are using, how they eat this camel flesh. This is haram in the Sharia of Musa. So Quran says no. It has never been declared haram. And here are the alfaz, here are the wordings. من قبل أن تنزل التوراة This actually decision was taken by Hazrat Yaqub alayhi salam before the coming down of Torah. Torah was given to Hazrat Musa alayhi salatu wasalam about nearly 300 years after Hazrat Yaqub alayhi salatu wasalam. In Torah there is no injunction. Qul fatu bi Torah fatluha in kuntum sadiqeen. Now this is the challenge that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given. You bring forth Torah and now read it. If there is any injunction which forbids and declares haram the flesh of camel, then your objection is okay. But if there is no injunction in the Torah, then it is actually, Quran is giving the explanation. It was not declared haram by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It was actually disliked by Yaqub alayhi salatu wasalam. He decided not to use it. And his progeny thought that it is haram. This is why, you know, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was forbidden. When, you know, he declared a certain sort of honey, certain type of honey. He decided, I will never take it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, he then sent down those ayat which are in the beginning of Surah Al-Tahreem. Ya ayyuhan nabiyyu lima tuharrimu ma ahallallahu lak. Why are you swearing that you will not use and you will not eat something which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has declared halal and permissible for you? Because the same, you know, mistake could have happened with the Muslim Ummah also then. Because an action of the Prophet, it becomes very important. People take it to be law. كل الطعام كان حلالا لبني إسرائيل إلا ما حرم إسرائيل على نفسه من قبل أن تنزل التوراة قل فأتوا بالتوراة فاتلوها إن كنتم صادقين. So bring forth Torah and read it if you are truthful. فمن افترى على الله الكذب من بعد ذلك. Whosoever forges a lie against Allah or on Allah after this, then they are surely the unjust people. قل صدق الله. Say, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah has said the truth. Allah has told you the truth. فَاتَّبِعُوا مِلَّةَ إِبْرَاهِيمَ حَنِيفًا. So you should follow the practices and the path of Ibrahim, who was away from all falsehood. وَمَا كَانَ مِنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ. And he was also not from those who associate anybody or anything with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as partners or equals.